tune in to Floridian Rollo. Let's go. I'm your host, Floridian Rollo. Let's go. Give me 1 second. Can y'all hear me loud and clear? How you doing, Terrific Tasha? Thank y'all for liking the video ahead of time. I appreciate that. We're going to get into this topic. I saw New Breed's video. Shout out to New Breed. I know Ringo's going to touch on it. I saw Mark the Messenger touch on it on the upload. Guys and ladies, ever since the April 8th thing, there's been a lot of things been going on. And the shift is changing. And these people are going buck wild, going crazy. So this particular person was an astrologer. I don't know what state, to be honest. And she ended up taking out her man who knew she was doing these things and didn't let her know to change her ways, for one. And then one of their children also, I believe was 8 months old, was also gone. I'm going to give you 5 things to be aware of. I'm going to deal with the men first. Guys, to know if a woman is dibbling and dabbling into different things, right? It's 3 types of smells that you know the woman is into: Wicca, witchcraft, astrology, Wicca, astrology, witchcraft, right? First and foremost, a lot of them is into the art. Yes, some of them into the art. What I mean by that is, what you're trying to say, Ronald? You're saying that most women that's into the art is into witchcraft? Absolutely. I'm going to prove it to you. I want to prove it to you. Give me time while we have this conversation. Think about it this way. A lot of musicians, right? They dabble and dabble into that. Would y'all agree? Put a one in the chat. Would y'all agree? A lot of musicians dabble and dabble into that. That art of witchcraft, Wicca, they dabble and dabble to many things to have a possess of a particular being. So it's not the person that you're talking to. It's that particular being that they summon that is the one you're listening to. And what it do is it collect as many souls as possible to go into the fire. Like New Breed said, they have nothing on us. I know that there are those out there that do that. They have photos of us. They've been trying to do certain things. And then the Most High eventually jacked them up because they don't repent. They keep doing it, keep doing it, keep doing it. The next thing you know, something happens to them or somebody close to them. Something happens to them, right? So art, there's different types of art. Art musician, they can possess a skill of having photos in certain localities and use it and stomp on it. What they do is they stomp on your face, right? They do certain enchantments, stomp on your face. They put certain cards there and they summon this entity to try to destroy your relationship with people, try to isolate you from everybody, try to have everybody don't talk to you, right? There are family members, there's people I talk with who have family members that were into that, whether it be grandma, aunties, older cousins, or she might have a man that she was dealing with and his family was into it. This is why you have to be cognizant of being around certain people. And what they do is, let's say hypothetically, they be a little bit more passionate with you. They try to get a piece of your hair. And what they do with the piece of the hair is put it in some type of thing and try to grow that hair, right? Try to grow your hair and then try to have everybody look at you as evil, right? So if you're not with the Most High and they happen to know you're not with the Most High, you have that certain order. How many of you ladies been with a guy? Everything seemed good. And the next thing you know, he not himself. You see that he not himself. Or vice versa. Fellas, how many ladies you got with? And she don't even know that there's certain families doing attachment to her relationship. People that you think is close to you could do enchantments right now to make sure that that relationship doesn't go according. This is why you got to be very cognizant and mindful who you share this information with. Sometimes it's best to not tell everybody, like ladies telling, you're telling your friends, you tell a certain family members, and you're just telling them, hey, I met somebody, he's doing pretty good for himself. And you show them a picture. Do you know what that, they don't have to take a snap or screenshot. They could remember that photo and draw it. Listen to what I'm saying. True story. They could look at that photo and draw that photo. And the next thing you know, your life ain't the same. If you're not strong, you don't have that strong foundation with that man and connected to the Most High. So I'm telling y'all, man, people do a lot of things. So without further ado, let's get to the clip. Hit the thumbs up. Support the Cash App. The Cash App is pinned to the top. We're going to get to the clip right now. So give me a second. Now I got a little bit of a cold. This narcissistic weather that they doing to us up here and throughout the region. Hold on a second. We're gonna get to it. So you're going to see the drawing. I want you to see the drawing of the avatar. This is how serious it is, okay? You're going to see the drawing. Okay, we know about this. You see this drawing right here? They draw. They can remember a photo and draw you. And in that drawing, they could put blood, the menstrual cycle, the woman, the man, he could put the semen and have you possessed through the photo, okay? They could have you possessed through the photo if you don't have that spirit of the Holy Spirit reside in you. They could use it against you. They don't have to use the thing, the puppet thing, like back in the days, they could do it through their art. So let's listen to this witch.
Today, every bit.
Let's listen to this witch. Here we go.
That you can dive in and start creating art magic today. Let's do it, moon babies. One, draw, paint, or doodle a picture of your heart's truest desire.
This ain't no different than astrology. This ain't no different than the industry. This is what I'm saying. Be cognizant. Not everybody that draw is evil. At the same time, if they're not careful, they could summon the art demon. There's a thing called the art demon. Look it up. There's a thing called the art drawing demon. They could make you draw certain things and then you put something in there that you're not supposed to put in that photo, and if you're not careful, it will whoop upside your head, the person that's doing it. And if the person is righteous and have done no wrong to you, no harm to you, it can ricochet right back to somebody you close to or to you. Let's go.
Okay, so that's kind of a doozy to start with. But art magic doesn't have to be fancy.
Here we go. Grab
a piece of paper or a notebook and create a picture of your heart's truest desire, whatever that desire is. There is no right or wrong answer. Creating images of our wishes, goals.
And that's what Eve did with the Debo. Eve has her art. Listen carefully. Eve used the art plants. It's called the art plants. And she used that to convince Adam to go against the Most High. There's more to it than what meets the eye. You see what this says? This goes back to the book of the garden. They use the subliminal messages talking about the time of the black devil, Eve, and Adam, who, by the way, went against the Most High. He had other ladies, and he was condemned because of following Eve. Let's go.
Dreams, wants, needs, and desires is big time, powerful magic. 2, make and send enchanted snail mail.
Told y'all. You
can send a miniature art spell to a friend or a loved one through the post. Decorate an envelope and dab it with some perfume. You could alter a postcard or a book page with pens.
Be careful what you get from these people. A lot of these mailing services is down with dipping and dabbing into witchcraft too. That's why you have to, anything you touch, you pretty much have to say to the Most High, may you protect me, because you don't know what people be putting in these mouths, in these drinks, anything. We in a wicked society such as never before. So everything is probability. It's not to be a scare tactic. My hands are clean in terms of the book of Ezekiel. Let's go.
Paint. You can write a beautiful wish or a heartfelt note or illustrate that wish for a friend. You could create confetti from blessed paper. You know how fun it is to receive love mail? It's even more fun to send it.
Wow.
3, color mindfully as a form of meditation.
Here we go. You can
color coloring pages as a form of meditation. Go to your sacred nook or altar. Choose a coloring page that suits your mood, your needs, or a magical aim. Light a candle and enjoy a session of mindful coloring. Really paying attention to what you're doing. Being.
Let me talk to the people that draws. I want to talk to you. Be mindful of the drawing and what type of ink you use, because not all ink is of good. Some ink is of evil. I forget the name of the movie where the person was drawing the person and that incident was happening accurately based on the drawing. I forget the name of the movie. And some of these movies may be novels. It could be also a true story. Sometimes they don't put true story. I forget the name of the movie where the person was drawing a particular person and that person lived accordingly to the drawing. This stuff is real, y'all. Let's go.
In your body and enjoying the process. If you are looking for some witchy magical coloring pages,
there we go.
Link in the down bar to my coloring book, as well as a collection of free coloring pages on the blog. 4, decorate a recycled object for your altar. What do you have lying around that wants to be refreshed and given a new life? Paint a porcelain cat knickknack a bold color to stand in as an animal guide. Embellish a plant pot with
paint. A lot of you guys and ladies in the truth, y'all do certain drawings, right? Y'all do certain drawings. I'm just saying, be cognizant of what you're drawing in what you're creating because it may not be of the Most High, respectfully. Learn the stuff you're getting, who you're getting it from. Do the research, do the background check, because you might be casting spells without realizing you're casting spells. I'm not kidding. I forget the name of the movie. The person thought they was doing a good deed by drawing a certain individual, not realizing in that movie the person was living subconsciously through the person's art because it was not of the Most High. It was of Satan, okay? This stuff is real. That's why you got to be mindful of what you wear. You got to be mindful of a lot of things because it could be used against you and it might be not of the Lord. Let's go. Not doing fear tactic. I'm just talking to my artists and artists.
Paint markers. Decorate a glass bottle to house your secret spells and wishes. Trash is truly the muse of the art niche. 5. Create a portrait of your most powerful self.
There we go.
What do you most wish to feel? What does your most...
You got people idolize their own selves. It's nothing wrong drawing if you're going to be doing it of the Lord, because there was a lot of people that was drawing in the biblical days. At the same time, you got people that's drawing that is not of the truth and could, you know, man, let's continue. This stuff is crazy.
Most magical, most empowered, whole, peaceful self look like. Create this most powerful self portrait with photo collage, digital collage, drawing, painting, or playing dress up and enjoying an empowering photo shoot. Put it in your grimoire as an aspirational talisman for growth. 6. Craft a piece of wearable art magic.
Here we go.
Buttons, pins, jewelry, charms, keychains, patches, bags, and hair accessories are all fun and wonderful ways to bring your art magic with you throughout the day. Make a pinback button for courage, a necklace for healing. Paint a pair of thrift store earrings in your power color. Dye a pair of canvas sneakers to bring the spirit of play with you wherever you roam. 7. Cut and paste a mini collage for your wallet. This one's fun. Create an itty-bitty art spell to carry in your wallet or bag by collaging a business card.
Do you know that women, if the woman knows your wallet, right? If the woman knows your wallet, she could draw your wallet, and the next thing you know, you're not making money. They could use that. They could summon it. They could summon a certain entity, and the next thing you know, you're wondering why you broke. So sometimes, man, these people, man, they could get possessed, man, if they're not careful. Let's continue.
With images, stickers, and words for luck, smooth travel, opportunities, love, abundance, or anything else your little magical heart desires. 8. Create a magical stamp. Using a craft knife, carefully carve a personal symbol into a pink eraser. Boom, instant magical stamp. Use this stamp to sign letters, petition papers, empower your grimoire pages, make personalized enchanted stationery, or seal your spells.
Seal your spell.
9. Hide an art magic spell in public.
Wow.
This is some ninja level art witching, but you can do it. It's so much fun. Tuck a secret drawing into a library book to attract other magical co-conspirators. Stash an origami frog in the grocery store to spread abundance and joy. Draw symbols and inspired scenes on the sidewalks of your neighborhood with chalk. How can you enchant your building, your workplace, your neighborhood with your art magic? If any of these ideas sound fun and you want to make your art magic missions into a game, you can play along with Art Magic Bingo. you can pop on over to the site and download your Art Magic Bingo printable. Get three in a row or fill up the whole card.
You see that laugh? You see that laugh? That's that witchery laugh, y'all.
You can do it. Have fun with it, Moon Babies. And while you're grabbing your printable, make sure you sign up for Moon Baby Mail so that I can send you free goodies and the occasional love letter sprinkled into your inbox. It doesn't matter what you create, Moon Baby.
You notice the lady sprinkle, sprinkle. Sprinkle, sprinkle dibbles into witchcraft. Listen, sprinkle, sprinkle dibbles into witchcraft. And a lot of ladies is using her witchcraft on a lot of you men. And she got warlocks now. You got warlocks calling themselves Soft Error. Guys, look it up. A lot of people's talking about it. You got men calling themselves Soft Error, and you got certain content creators, you know, into the Soft Error, Soft Men Era. That's warlocks. Because I forget what they say the name is. They doing a chant right now. There's a chant going on out there. It's getting out of control. And you're going to have these young men doing the opposite of sprinkle, sprinkle. Don't mention her name in the chat. So you got this thing with these guys now is probably sprinkle, sprinkle told the men, you know, come up with your own name so we can make some serious money. So you got some content creators agreeing with it. That's why I tell you that you have to be mindful and cognizant. You got men out here that want to be opposite of sprinkle, sprinkle. This is crazy, man. Yo, all these distractions, they trying to put on the chosen ones, more so on the men that's righteous. Because, you know, they have destroyed the chosen one. They destroyed it. They destroyed that word. New Breed has put it to a stop, which is because that's his coin. And they have made it witchcraft and warlock. You know what I'm saying? So, like, everything we do, you got these entities making it look evil, just like the polygyny with Dirty Dollar, right? With Dirty Dollar has made it look evil, polygyny, which is not evil, yet because, you know, a lot of people know him, now people are going to question polygyny. They're going to think it's witchcraft, and it's not witchcraft. So there's a lot of things we're battling against. Excuse me. Let's continue to listen to this.
Only that you start. I can't wait to see what kind of magic you create. I want to thank you so much for being here and being you. And until we speak again, witch on, witch boldly, and be well, my friends. Bye for now.
Our internet bill went up?
Looks like you need Verizon.
I'm telling y'all, man. Stay away from these people. Stay away from these people for real. I'm not mentioning her name. Now I'm gonna show y'all what the soft whatchamacallit error. This is crazy. This is crazy. Look at this. Soft guy error. This is going on. Listen to look at the warlocks. Look at the warlocks. The witch is sprinkle, sprinkle. Now we're gonna look at these warlocks. Look at this. This is crazy, man. I'm telling you. You got certain content creators agreeing with this. They're okay with this. Look at this. Hold on. Why I don't hear nothing on here? Hold on a second, y'all. Hold on. Can y'all guys hear me? Put a one in the chat if you can hear me. 1 second. Hold on. Why it's not working? Hold on. Let me check my mic. Mic check. Let me see what's going on. Okay, everything's good. Why is the YouTube not working? Hold on 1 second, y'all. Let me see something. Oh, it's muted. My mistake. I had it muted. I forgot I muted the thing. Okay, we're getting back to it. I forgot I mute the other one before we get to this. All right, here we go. Watch this.
Advocating for soft guy era. And the funny thing is, a lot of ladies are really angry at him. And the fact that they cannot recognize and acknowledge that he is joking and trying to actually let them realize how they sound. So women are actually angry when they are served the food they have been dishing out for us for all this while. Yes, he is in his soft guy era. If you cannot take him to a five-star restaurant, then he doesn't want to have anything to do with you. And he has every right to say that, because that is what you guys have been saying all the time. So no broke men, that is cool. No broke girls, because we are in our soft guy era. There is this guy.
Okay, let's get to the other one. You know he's saucy. Here's this one.
Era. This is what y'all wanted. Now you got it. Men are now saying, if you ain't going 50-50, I don't want your ass. Forget you. Ladies, this your fault. It's all y'all fault. A couple of y'all ran your mouth. Not all of y'all, but some of y'all started talking a bunch of stupid shit, and now men ain't having it no more. The sad part is, this happened right before summertime. Ain't gonna be no twerking, ain't gonna be no fun this summer. Everybody gonna be in the club, just standing on the wall, just looking at each other. It's gonna be dead outside. The ladies gonna twerk on each other in the section. Niggas gonna be at the bar just looking. The crazy part is, the soft guy era been going on for decades now. For many years now, there's been women who have taken care of men, no cap. If your dick big enough and you know how to use it, a woman will take care of you, no cap. The gender war is...
Pause. Y'all see what we dealing with? Sprinkle has gotten a person in question to get these guys to do opposite of what she's doing. Guys, we live in a time such as never before. Like the Bible says, we live in a time such as never before. This is all sorcery. And it's unfortunate, because you're going to have... Listen to what he just said.
It's officially here, the soft guy era. This is what y'all wanted. Now you got it. Men are now saying, if you ain't going 50-50, I don't want your ass. Forget you. Ladies, this your fault. It's all y'all fault. A couple of y'all ran your mouth. Not all of y'all, but some of y'all started talking a bunch of stupid shit, and now men ain't having it no more. The sad part is, this happened right before summertime. Ain't gonna be no twerking, ain't gonna be no fun this summer. Everybody gonna be in the club, just standing on the wall, just looking at each other. It's gonna be dead outside. The ladies gonna twerk on each other in the section. Niggas gonna be at the bar just looking. The crazy part is, the soft guy era been going on for decades now. For many years now, there's been women who have taken care of men, no cap. If your dick big enough and you know how to use it, a woman will take care of you, no cap.
All right, let's get to the next one. Oh my goodness, man, this is crazy. You can't make this up. Here we go again.
woman asks you to be her husband, you don't have to do husband-like things. Stop giving these women husband advantages and amenities, and you're still a boyfriend. Until that ring is on your finger, you shouldn't be doing anything. Period. Drizzle, drizzle.
Those TikTok videos are going viral right now. And the hyenas in the comment section are absolutely upset and trying to get them banned because they're making fun of just how they're basically exposing the bad behavior that women in, you know, women in 2024, especially here in the West, are guilty of.
I don't know who needs to hear this, but until that woman asks you to be her husband, you don't have to do husband-like things. Stop giving these women husband advantages and amenities, and you're still a boyfriend. Until that ring is on your finger, you shouldn't be doing anything. Period. Drizzle, drizzle.
Those TikTok videos are going viral right now. And the hyenas in the comment section are absolutely upset and trying to get them banned.
Hold on 1 second. God darn it. Hold on 1 second, y'all. Let's get to the next one. Let's get to the next one.
Tell that bitch stop playing. Hey, tell that bitch stop playing. Tell that bitch stop playing. Hey, tell that bitch stop playing. Tell that bitch stop playing. Hey, hey. Tell that bitch stop playing.
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 Hey, tell that bitch stop playing.
Tell that bitch stop playing.
Tell that bitch stop playing.
Hey, listen, y'all. This is getting real, ladies. Ladies, you got Sprinkle Sprinkle. Got these dudes now calling themselves Drizzle Drizzle. Yo, this is crazy, man. Woo. That dude from Soft Era said 2024. You ladies gonna be dancing on each other, and men gonna be looking at each other at the club, man. This is, whoo. This Western society is in trouble. This Western society in trouble. This dude with his Mercedes going in with some music, man. We're in a lawless society. We're in a Sodomite and Gomorrah society. We are in the time such as never before in this Babylon. The cup is filled with evil on top of evil on top of evil. My goodness. Let's get the response from the chicks. Let's get the response from the chicks. Here we go.
Graham streets, okay, and I ran across a reel, okay, and the reel said men are in their soft guy era. It says men are in their soft guy era. So they found a way to combat that foolery of Sprinkle Sprinkle. you can't make it up, okay. So now it's Drizzle Drizzle. Woo! They say they taking all comers. They want scammers, okay? They want street pharmacists. They said, you got to pay me for my time. How does it sound, ladies? How does it sound, baby? This is the same foolery y'all been putting on social media. How does it sound? Take heed to. So I was in the Instagram streets, okay, and I ran across a reel, okay, and the reel said, men are in their soft guy era. It says, men are in their soft guy era. So they found a way to combat that foolery of Sprinkle Sprinkle. You can't make it up, okay? So now it's Drizzle. Woo! They said they taking all comers. They want scammers, okay? They want street pharmacists. They said, you got to pay me for my time. How does it sound, ladies?
Well, I mean, sprinkles in on it because she got a guy to be opposite of her. Just like when the guy started traveling, you got a passport sister movement and you got the passport bro movement. It's always competing between the man and the woman. It's always competing, and it's not for the right reasons. Both are for the wrong reasons. Sprinkle, drizzle, is for the wrong reason. This is all about separation. They want us separated. They don't want us together. And you know what's the crazy part? Them dudes getting a lot of money just being soft. And I wouldn't be surprised if the women is supporting this soft guy era. Because, ladies, let me ask you this question. Are you okay with a man being the soft guy era? Are you going to rather talk to him than a man that's a man in your perspective? This is not looking good. This is not looking good. This lady is married, by the way. She married talking about this. Oh, let's see who else talking about it. Let's get some more of this. Okay, she gotta talk about it.
This whole soft. That I think that whole aesthetic TikTok thing is BS. Honestly, I don't like it. It's very sugar-coated, package it up and sell it to people. But there are women who are out there who are really trying to better themselves. Some of the pushback we get is that it's not believable.
Soft girl life is about getting your nails done, pedicures and manicures, mm-hmm. and looking the part. That's not your shortcoming. So what is it that men actually want for a lifetime instead of for a night? I'm telling you that your legs are fully developed. You need to work your upper body. The next few times I see you in the gym, you're still doing squats.
Mm-hmm. I hear you. This whole soft girl era is a thing. And I will say that.
So they learned it from Sprinkle in the soft girl era. I'm telling you, this is all an agenda. This is all an agenda. This is crazy, man. This is the low of the low. Let's listen to what this woman got to say.
What do the table?
Other women, because all that other stuff is too hard for you to do. You don't want to do it anyway. You naturally bring women around and you're uninteresting. How else are you going to keep me interested in you? The least you could do is bring another girl around. And if you knew anything about men, you'd realize that.
What do women need to bring to the table?
Other women, because all that other stuff is too hard for you to do. You don't want to do it anyway. You naturally bring women around and you're uninteresting. How else are you going to keep me interested in you? The least you could do is bring another girl around. And if you knew anything about men, you'd realize that.
Oh my goodness. Dude, you ain't even talk. You haven't seen a woman face to face in party since you came out your mom's room respectfully. Oh, let's listen to this situation. Oh, this is gonna be a long. I ain't got time for no long bit. No. Hold on. Let's listen to this broad, y'all.
We do more than just
fair use. Oh boy, here we go.
Hi everybody, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well. So in today's video, I would want you to follow.
And yes, she dibbled into the she's a witch, fellas. Look at her eyes. She got her lips done. That's not her natural lips. She's a witch. That's an actual witch that's talking about the soft guy era and the women like her. Let's listen to this clip, though.
Okay, so you understand the video. It is not going to be the usual topic and responses. I'm trying to tell a story. I'm not that good at it, so follow me. So you understand what I'm trying to bring to you, if it makes sense, okay?
I just got off the phone with someone I was seeing, and she asked me how my day was going, and I explained I was at the airport. And then she said, I'm glad you got there safe. And I said, yeah, I had to take an Uber. I had to block her. I mean, she was great and everything. She was emotionally intelligent, always paid for dinner, pretty much catered to my every need. But if you hear I'm taking an Uber to the airport and your first move is not to open up Venmo and send me money, are you even a real woman? And then you find out I'm on a commercial flight and you don't immediately charter me a private jet. I know my worth, Drizzle Drizzle. I'm in my soft guy era. I want to be pampered. And if you're broke, just say that. And I'm sure later she'll come around looking for some sugar, but this...
You got the it community. Just like Sprinkle Sprinkle is dealing with that dabble with the same sex. This guy deals with both sex. Make no mistake about it. He dibbles and dabble into men and women. It's okay with it. Women will drop their panties for this it. I'm telling y'all, man, this is a sick world, man. This is a sick Babylon. And you wonder why other countries are pulling their dollar away. You wonder why the Bible is being fulfilled. Because of all this nastiness that's going on, particularly in these Ibarazi states. In some of these so-called conservative states. Ladies, this is what you're chasing. Listen, he got more women in his inbox. He got a lot of ladies in his inbox. They'll throw their panties for him. Because he looked like he got something going on now looking at his deviant behavior. I'm telling you, this soft guy area is not normal.
Sugar don't mix without Drizzle.
I think you guys have heard about the Drizzle movement going on. It's everywhere on TikTok. And since TikTok keep giving me Drizzle here and there, I am just going to add my own 2 cents to the point.
How many of you remember I said that a lot of these men want to be women? Put a Y in the chat. How many of you remember I said that these men want to be women? This is the proof right here. I said this less than a month ago. I said this less than a month ago. And I said it with Newbury and Ringo on the panel when we was talking about certain things at the time. I said that with Ringo and Newbury on the panel. So this is clarification for it. Show some love to the Cash App. Show some love to the Cash App for speaking this truth. Let's get 3 more Cash Apps. Let's go. Let's get 3 more Cash Apps. Support the stream.
Oh, right. So what is Drizzle Drizzle? Drizzle Drizzle is a group of men, or if not all of them, saying that they are in their soft guy era now, and they are demanding that women pay them for their time, okay? So they are the, as one of the ladies said, Denzels in distress. Now they are not going to be in their masculine energy. They're expecting some kind of treatment from women, okay? Hence the videos I showed before, okay? But others are saying, oh, it's just a satire. It's just men putting mirrors in women's faces so women can see themselves and hear themselves when they talk about their standards and their preferences, okay? And it's in response to the Sprinkle Sprinkle movement. So I know they said it's a satire, but I also know that a lot of guys are going to take this seriously, i.e.
We're anesthesiologists, surgeons.
For Papa Do's, like, come on. But you a boss bitch, though. Like, I've never been the 4-4 type of nigga. You gotta treat me. I'm glad the soft guy era is in full effect now, because to be honest, we tired of paying for y'all shit. Like, real talk. We just tired. It's about time that y'all return the favor and treat us like the kings that we are. So go ahead and spend that. We need it. I like nice things, too.
Oh, we know exactly what you ladies want, but we're not giving it anymore. Drizzle, Drizzle. We're done with the patriarchy and this old archaic way of doing things where we're supposed to provide and protect for you, where we're supposed to be willing to risk and give our lives for you. Listen, we don't need to bring anything to the table because we are the table. Without my seed, you can't have any kids, Drizzle, Drizzle. So what you gonna do about that? Listen, we are in our soft guy era. I need to get my beard taken care of every Tuesday. So I'm going to need you to go ahead and send $75 to my barber via cash.
What I say? Newbury and Ringo, Mark the Messenger, if you listening, your guys need to get in on this soft guy era. If you brothers are listening to this channel in the clouds, you need to get on this because now we need the bigger platforms to talk about it. I done started the alarm. I sounded the alarm. Newbury, Ringo, Mark the Messenger, when you get in touch with this video, do your research. I'm telling you right now, you got a lot of men that want to be women. They don't want to be men no more. That's why the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 4, verse 1, in that day, seven women shall hold on to one man. Let us be called by thy name and reproach. Because you're going to have a lot of men don't want to deal with you. These guys are in that entity right now. They are retrograded. It's not only the women that's retrograded with the sprinkle, sprinkle, drizzle, drizzle, it's retrograde. They're not going to change. You could show him the best time, ladies, and it's still not enough for him. My, oh, my, oh, my. This is crazy. Let's go.
Cash App every Tuesday before I get there so that I can get my hair taken care of. Drizzle, drizzle. All right? And when you get your taxes from working hard all year while I stay at home and play PlayStation, I need you to give me the whole amount so I can flip it for us. Drizzle, drizzle. Oh, yes, yes, yes. We're no longer being providers and protectors and buying into the patriarchal system of letting you guys get on the boat first if the sink is shipping. No, 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 no. We're done with those days. We are equal now, so we will get on the boat based upon whoever is the strongest. Drizzle, drizzle. All right? So don't ask us to do anything, provide anything. If we go out to eat, 50-50. Drizzle, drizzle. If you have another kid by another man, 50-50. Drizzle, drizzle.
Now, she's saying they have no clue what we require. I think it's rather hilarious. A man just can't compete with me and my peace. And you got some dudes on YouTube agreeing with her. You got men on here saying we should separate from the women, and you got women on here saying we should separate from the men. They're already doing the Agenda 2020. Listen, the powers that be ain't got to force the mark of the beast. The powers ain't be got to force you to do anything. These people are voluntary. I told you, and many brothers in the truth told you by the Most High perspective in Christ, that you're going to have people voluntarily doing the Agenda 2030, and they're going to depopulate. Because the powers that be know the masses of the people is going to hell. They're not going to repent. They retrobase. We just bringing out the receipts. Let's go.
Because when a man says he's joking, I don't even know if it's a joke. Okay. A lot of women are in support of this movement, and they are saying that women brought it upon themselves. And others are not in support of it because they are like, this is ridiculous. I'm going to play some of the clips from the women who are in support of the Drizzle Drizzle movement. Then I'll go. Come back and play some of the videos of the ladies who are not in support of it. So before I get into that, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Okay? And let's get into that.
Y'all bullied men so much that they're all now banding together to enter their soft guy era. You bullied them and said that they're toxic if they're too masculine. Being a tough guy or a macho manly guy isn't going to work for women. Well, you bullied them and it worked. And guess what? Aren't going to be happy about the monsters you create. Sorry, beautiful monsters you created with all this drizzle, drizzle, soft guy energy entering the chat. Well, guess what, ladies? Who's going to take out the garbage? The guys have all joined a pack together and said, it's your job to take out the garbage. Who's going to be the passenger princess? Not you, it's him. All of these guys are joining together to now be in their soft guy era. And I don't think it's going to change. In fact, expect more sass. Just when you thought you had too much sass in a relationship, just being you, more sass has entered the relationship. I don't know what y'all created, why you did this. Honestly, go for men. Good for you. As much as I love a manly man, I also love a man who is in tune with their feminine side, in tune with their emotions. I do think guys deserve it, just like we do. I would never ask something for myself.
She married to something. She married to something or to herself. Because you got a lot of these ladies wearing wedding rings and they to themselves. I'm telling y'all, the sickness is crazy.
Self that I wouldn't give in return. If I ask you to go get my water or go get me a snack, better believe that I'm cooking you dinner and I'm doing your laundry. Frank here is a male cat, so he has also entered his soft guy era. Frank,
what? Frank,
it's great.
What? Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no. She said the cat, too. Here we go.
The men have decided if you can't beat them, join them.
Wow.
So drizzle, drizzle to your sprinkle, sprinkle. Okay? At the end of the day, you told men that they were toxic just for being men. You told men that strength and macho behavior and all the rest of the things that come along with being a man, those things are all bad. Put them away. Okay. They said no problem. They have no problem being in their soft guy era. So I hope you're not concerned about who's going to be taking out the trash, because guys have decided you, princess, you get to take out the trash. And while we're talking about royalty, I hope you're not wanting to be a passenger princess, because these guys, they want that treatment too. Fair is fair.
It's a wrap, y'all. It's a wrap. Fellas, fellas in the truth. Get ready for Isaiah 4:1, because the more of these dudes that's going to come out and agree with this, it's not only these guys that work in these sites. You got athletes that's thinking like that too, and some of the world leaders. So it's all going to come out, all right? So you're going to have some of these women knocking on your door in the future, and they're going to be like, listen, I can't be out here. Can you take me in? Because it's crazy out here. There's not too many actual men that want to be men no more. So we are willing to listen and want to be called by your name and reproach, meaning we're willing to help. We're willing to build your foundation, because these men don't want to be men no more. And some of these ladies agree with you being a feminized. I don't agree with it. You should not be a feminized. So, hey, this is crazy, y'all. This is going to be talked about for at least a month or two. And it's not going anywhere anytime soon, because this is going to lead to Isaiah 4:1. Just get ready, fellas. It's about to get serious this summer.
Fair, right? Anything you can do, they can do. All right, well, they've decided to match your sass, and now they're embracing it. So I hope that you get everything that you wanted, because ladies, y'all have created some monsters, okay?
Buckle up. She said that. She said
that. And enjoy the ride. I don't think it's ending anytime soon. Drizzle, drizzle.
Do you know what I find insane? Everybody keeps asking me what I think about the drizzle, drizzle movement. I'm all for it. I literally talk about men's mental health all the time. I'm always on men's side. So, of course, I'm going to ride for this fucking movement. And here's another thing. Whenever that soft guy merch, comes out or whatever, I'm going to buy about 10 of those outfits and pass them to my followers or whatever so they can wear it, send me pictures, and then I'll post it all over my stuff. Anything that has to do with black men rising to the top, I support it. You women that are getting upset at this soft guy era drizzle drizzle, what are you mad about? Y'all had your fun with I Hate Men movement, the Me Too movement, sprinkle, sprinkle, and all this stuff. And that sprinkle, sprinkle lady, that hyena lady or whatever that talks like this, she literally encourages you guys to take men's money. The soft guy movement is just about men getting treated right, getting loved and cherished as well. If you get mad at that, something's wrong with your head. Larga de aquí. If you're mad at it, pow, pow, pow. That's how soft
I don't know what's better. Is these dudes fighting back about taking their gym back and not being called gym creeps anymore?
Yeah, a lot of men ain't going to the gym no more, because a lot of you ladies have falsified harassment. It's not to say that they don't exist, yet now the gyms is, it's not a lot of men going to the gym. I'm okay with that. If you are calling certain men creeps and they're not creeps and you're lying on them, and you recorded them and they're not looking at your physique, they just focusing on concentrating on their workout. You just happen to bend over, you do certain things to try to get their attention. So a lot of guys have found their own ways to get a gym. I don't agree with the soft guy era. Let me make that clear. I don't agree with it. What I'm saying is I do agree with men letting y'all be to your own vices. Since you want to, you know, say men as being dirty creeps and stuff like that, not all men go to the gym as dirty creeps. Some men go there, work out. If you look good, you look good. I mean, you're showing your physique. Like, I get it. You don't, it's what you want to wear. At the same time, I mean, like, the guy may stare a little bit. It's not like he's staring all day. Like, y'all making it to seem like he's doing it all day. And that's why a lot of men have opted out. That's why a lot of gyms close, because we know men make most of the, put more effort into the workouts than most of you ladies do. Okay? Let's just keep it real. Other than that, let's hear what she has to say.
Or this drizzle, because girl, the way these men are fighting back has me cackling.
All right, so Zats want to enter in. Let me put the link for Zats. Zats said he want to come on. Okay. I paused it. Let me put Zats in. We need two more Cash Apps. Let's go. We need two more Cash Apps. We got 26 folks in here. We getting into the greasy out here. We putting in this work. All praises to the Lord. We need two more Cash Apps. Let's go. All right. I'm waiting for Zass to come in before we continue. We're waiting for Zass to enter in the chat. So make sure you like the video, share this video, put it out there. You know, the algorithm. We're going to get a lot of views because I'm going to put Soft Guy Era, stay alert out here. Witches, Warlocks. Let me change the title because that's going to bring more people to the chat. Let me change the title right now. We're going to do it for the algorithm. Yeah. Let me change the title. Let me add on to it. Come on in, guys. Come on in. Hit the link, fellas. Yeah, I gotta put this on the algorithm right now. What's going on, Zats?
Fam. No. I do not. What's it called? The soft boy era?
Yeah.
First of all, We're calling ourselves boys when we're men. So that's one issue. The other issue, right? You know what? Hold on. First of all, thanks for having me on, fam.
No problem.
I appreciate it, man. I was just tuning in and I was like, what's going on here? And then I'm just listening. I'm like, hold up. What's drizzle? And I'm saying to myself, is this the male version of Sprinkle?
Correct.
So think about it. Not only that they're doing witchcraft, and Ringo spoke about this in his 9-hour stream with his 9-hour stream recently today, I think. He was saying that the reason why the women are wicked is because we're wicked. I agree. We're not leading these women.
Yeah.
We are technically following them again.
Yes. That's right.
We're doing the same thing they were doing first. So not only that we're practicing witchcraft, we're following Eve again.
Yep.
So this is another L for us.
Yeah.
Like I said, I'm just listening through. I'm like, wait a second. Okay, how is this gonna get the woman right? So we're just gonna do the same thing women are doing. No, we should not invest into that sprinkle sprinkle nonsense. That's the issue. We're still investing into the sprinkle sprinkle nonsense by doing the same thing women were doing. That makes us even more effeminate.
Yep.
Oh man.
Let's continue.
Yeah,
let's continue. I am in love with this Drizzle Drizzle.
Wow.
Because the way these women are losing their damn minds, and these men's comment sections are getting blown the hell up. I don't know which one I like more. You know what? I do know. I love the Drizzle Drizzle more. I love the Drizzle Drizzle more because you have so many delusional women out here thinking that they were doing something with their, what is it, 4B, 4A, 4 don't give a shit. And they expect these men to just roll over and take it. These women have done nothing short of absolutely obliterate men for the last few years. Now you're going to learn what consequences are because these men aren't going to take it anymore. They're not going to take it anymore. So the masculinity, the machismo.
I can't hear it.
What is it? The high value, all of the garbage that these women put out.
I don't know if it's her video.
You can't hear it?
I don't know if you're talking too. I can't hear you.
No, I'm not talking. It's the lady talking.
Oh, I can't hear you. Hold on. Let me leave first.
All right. Can y'all hear me in the chat? Can y'all hear me? Put a one in the chat if y'all can hear me. Put a one in the chat if y'all can hear me loud and clear. I'm waiting for Zaz to come back. Okay. I'm waiting for Zaz to come back. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Okay, let's get back to the clip.
All right.
Y'all are going to learn. Put your boots on. Put your boots on, because I cannot wait for these construction workers, for these men that do these disgusting, dirty jobs so women's hands can stay clean. I can't wait till they start quitting. And then we're all going to be shit out of luck.
Did you hear what you just said? You there? Zach, you there? What's going on here? Hold on a second, y'all. You there, Zach?
Yeah, I'm here. I think my headphones were like messed up, so I just disconnected them.
She said that she can't wait for the construction men and men that do the dirty work go into the soft guy era so that everything can shut down. Did you hear me? I don't know what's going on with Zach's headsets, or is he on a computer? I don't know. Zach, can you hear me? Try to come back in if you can hear me. Yeah, Florida be like that sometimes, y'all. Florida be like that. Yeah, he can't get on his laptop. Get on your laptop, Zats. Because if you're on your phone, it's not going to work. Yeah, you're going to have to get on your laptop, fam. All right, let's continue. I'll see if let's wait for him to come back. Hold on. Let's wait for him to come back. God West says she's under a delusion, though, to think soft guys are good. They pushing the agenda, man. Sprinkle sprinkles in on it. This is a money grab. This is a money grab. Okay, let's continue, y'all. This is a money grab.
Because those women that demanded that these men stop being so masculine, that all of this masculinity is toxic. Lace up your boots, ladies. Lace up your boots. get out there and go take those jobs. Because, you know, everybody should be equal, right? You can do what a man can do. Lace those boots up.
While these women are saying, oh, women brought it upon themselves, it's their fault that men are in their soft guy era and so on and so forth, other women are like, absolutely not. Absolutely not. This is a shame. Okay. This is ridiculous. Any guy who speaks about the Drizzle is just insane. Like, you guys should stop it right now. Take a look at their views and opinions as well.
Drizzle Drizzle means I'm too broke to make it rain. Drizzle Drizzle means you need to make an appointment with your urologist. Stat. Drizzle Drizzle means I'm so maidenless that all I do with my time.
This is a witch. This is a witch, y'all. This is a super witch. A super duper witch. Okay?
Time is comment Drizzle Drizzle into the comment sections of women that I would have to pay to spend time with me. Drizzle Drizzle means mom, call the maintenance man. Drizzle Drizzle means you're so unoriginal that you have to piggyback off the creativity of women. I have yet to see one person with a picture of their actual face as their profile picture using the phrase Drizzle Drizzle.
Hey, what's up, y'all? So, you know, every time I get on this app, I'm getting secondhand embarrassment from you men. I don't know any of you all, but now y'all want to start this soft guy era. This Drizzle Drizzle movement, right? Listen, any man that's comfortable with a woman coming out of her purse or her pocket spending money on you, understand is you'll do the same with a man. A lot of these men, ladies, are just down low. They just...
Now, she does have a point because some of these dudes are questionable. Now, some of them is just going along with the trend to make money, which is even worse, okay? They're going along with the trend to make money. The thing is, she's down with Sprinkle Sprinkle. So a lot of these witches and warlocks are going to war with each other. They're going to war with each other right now. Let's go. She's definitely a witch.
Too insecure to come out the closet. You know, because this whole movement is perpetuated by them not really being, you know, for them being in their feminine energy, for them not wanting to be a lead with masculine energy, because when you're in your masculine energy, there comes responsibility. You don't want the responsibility, so you want to go in your female energy, your feminine energy, talking about you want to live a soft life. You a man. But a lot of you males don't really want the responsibility. So now you want to flip it and try to gaslight.
She's telling the truth. She's telling the truth at the same time. She ain't fooling me. I can see right through those glasses. She's telling the truth. Sometimes these entities could tell the truth that doesn't neglect the fact what they dibble or dabble into. Let's go.
Women into believing that they supposed to pay your way. Understand, it's the same thing that these men are trying to get women to do for them. They will allow a man to do it for the right price.
You're about the Drizzle Drizzle community and my For You page. And honestly, I am so glad that men just like have stopped pretending.
Yeah, she just had some, she had a dude come over and smash her recently. She had a dude come over and smash her recently, and she decided to get on TikTok and be prissy. Let's go. Let's see what she has to say.
I would much rather dusty men know their place and own the fact that they don't have the masculine characteristics to actually provide for a woman and be the leader of a family. The best part about them owning Drizzle Drizzle is the fact that it's going to make dating for women a lot easier. Because now men are not going to be hiding whether or not they're dusty, whether or not they're providers. I've had so many girls that's...
You know where she got that from, right? You know where she got that from. She got that from the chick that's been off of YouTube. Don't mention her name in the chat. She got that from the chick that been kicked off of YouTube earlier this year. So they watch our content, whether it's good or bad. So you got a lot of these Gentile women calling you guys dusties too. So for all you so-called black men thinking it's only so-called black women calling you dusty, you got these Gentile women calling you dusty, or these Latino women calling you dusty. Let's continue.
Stay in relationships for years because the guy convinces them that they're a provider even when they're not providing. And they future project to these women and they're like, yes, when we're married and when we have kids, I'm going to like buy you everything and you're going to be a stay-at-home mom, just for that to never happen. So now I'm really glad men are really, you know, standing up and being like, hey, I want to be treated like a woman. Because now women like us that want a provider and that want to stay in our feminine energy know who not to date. And just how there are women like us that would never touch a guy like that with a 10-foot pole, surprisingly, there are women that...
I'm not buying that. You probably don't... The thing about it is the chick that talk about dusty dudes allegedly had a child with a man that she would consider dusty in the community. That she would consider dusty in the community. So this chick right here, she done deal with some hood dudes. Stop the cap. You dealt with some hood dudes. You just talking your mouth. You probably just had one recently. And you just coming on here trying to, I'm just trying to get me a man that makes some money. No, you dealt with some dudes that probably didn't have something at the time and you was taking care of him. Stop the cap. Let's go.
That want that. There are women that want to take care of a man. Because just like how those guys think, oh, no guy is going to want a girl that sprinkle sprinkle, they have no idea that so many men want to take care of women, of the woman that they love. So for once and for all, let's stop fighting. Let's make women that want to provide for men get with men that want to be provided for. And let's let women that want to get provided for get with men that want to provide for them.
Grown-ass men coming on the internet talking about some drizzle.
Oh, no, not the Caribbean one. Oh, no. She like, brethren, what are you talking about drizzle, drizzle for? What I mean? What are you talking about? Look at her, how she come up in here trying to be cozy. Look at this Caribbean woman. What? What?
Women of the woman that they love. So for once and for all, let's stop fighting. Bro. Let's make women that want to provide for men get with men that want to be provided for. And let's let women that want to get provided for get with men that want to provide for them.
Grown-ass men coming on the internet talking about...
I know you brothers want to get up on her DMs. Listen, stop the cap. Brothers, I know you want to get up on her DM. You like, let me tell you something, girl. May not drizzle, you know. May want to see you right now. What y'all got on? You got on that robe? You got that sexy gown on, woman? What y'all talking about? Why y'all talking about drizzle, equal, brokey, brokey? What y'all mean, brokey, brokey? Who brokey, brokey? You didn't mean to tell me you never done with no brokey, brokey before? You're coming up in here with all the diamond wrists and everything? You're coming up in the robe. You're trying to, you're just trying to get a man right now. Who got the call for you? Who got them wall painters for you? What mind you got? You sprinkle them on? Let me see. You got your hair done. You got everything done. What are you talking about, brokey? What man brokey? She talking patois. What brokey? I'm going to tell you now, you got the Caribbean woman in there, brokey. That means broke. Let's continue. This is hilarious.
Some drizzle. Talking about some, I want my gas pumped too. I want my car door opened too. When we go on a date, I want to go 50-50. I am a damsel in distress.
Man, she clowning you dudes, man. She clowning y'all. She clowning y'all, man. Damn. She roasting.
Hoes only want us for our money. I promise you, drizzle man, none of the women that are in the sprinkle, the whole sprinkle, you are the caliber of men.
Stop the cap. You'll get with those drizzle dude. If that dude, that drizzle dude, pull up in that Maybach series that he had, you'll pull up. You'll be like, you know what? You're drizzle. I see you with that Mercedes. Let me go talk to you. Let me take a photo with you at the Mercedes. Some of those drizzle dudes you will holler at because they got some paper. They're just not man enough you know, in perspective of how, you know, men supposed to conduct themselves. However, some of them digital dudes are six figures. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know if he would say no to that. I don't know. I'm just saying, I don't know.
We do not want. Because what are you doing as a full-go man sitting in front of a camera with a ring light on a Monday morning at 10 a.m. talking about some, I want my door open too. Do you know how embarrassing that is?
Uh-oh.
Oh, women these days are not like women back in the days, because men back in the days did not sit and want their doors opened. Uh-oh. As a grown man, you want a woman to open your door?
Uh-oh.
You see, this is the thing. A lot of these men have been jealous of women for a very long time.
What?
Okay? If men don't want to be women, they want to act like us. If they cannot act like us, they attack us and tell us what to do, how to act, what to do with our bodies, and who we should date and who we should not. And when women take...
Which proves my point. She's been dealing with a lot of dudes. She got a different multitude of spirits in the men. She had a man over there, broke her back. You know what I'm saying? Gave her the work. And now she coming on her TikTok talking her ish. This is crazy, man. TikTok is crazy.
Take a stand against that. Oh my goodness, they are whores. They want our money. The type of money we want, none of the drizzle men on you have it.
I'm not going to say that. I'm not for the soft guy era. Some of them got money. They doing some things for strange change. They doing some strange change, just like you sprinkle chicks will do things for strange change. So let's not stop the cap now. You will do things for strange change too. So you ain't getting out of this. However, you're going in on a drizzle, guys. You're going at each other. The demons are fighting the demon chicks. Let's go.
No man that says drizzle on this internet has the type of money the sprinkle ladies are talking about. Well, they don't like when we say it, but it's okay for them to say, oh my goodness. Not a full-grown man clutching his pearls.
Wow.
Honestly, I am shocked and embarrassed and appalled for you guys. It's giving very much, bend me over. It's giving very much, oh, put my legs across your neck. Since you guys want to be passenger princesses so bad.
Wow.
You see, the drizzle men come from the same batch as the passport bros. Like, when God was creating this type of man...
Passport bros, they calling you out. Passport bros, they calling you out. Oh, man. Y'all know my thing. I'm a traveling man. I'm not with no passport bro community. Mm-mm. I'm a traveling man. At the same time, I ain't with that passport bro community. Nope. Let's continue. You see, Dirty Dower, just to get a little bit off subject. Dirty Dower, this is the type of woman you want. You want them sprinkle type of women. I'm telling y'all, man. Listen, 2024, ever since Cat Williams came on the scene, everything's coming out now. Yeah, I noticed that, right? Oh, prior to that, we've been talking about certain things. It's just that when Cat Williams hit the scene with the comedians, now all of this coming out. And we're not even in summertime. It's a wrap, y'all. It's a wrap tizzle. Let's go.
There was an ingredient he forgot to include. And these are the consequences that we're all facing. Ah! I am so appalled.
So apparently lonely men on the internet are saying drizzle as a response to sprinkle, which is like that whole women empowerment movement online started by the sprinkle lady. I actually don't know her name. I mean no disrespect by it. All the power to her. Keep doing what you're doing. If it's teaching women to take their power back, I'm all for it. But in response to this 4B movement where women are deciding they don't want men, they don't need men, they're just going to boycott men altogether. These men are now saying drizzle. And I feel like I'm being pulled into it because they're starting to comment that shit in my comment section of my videos simply because I'm a woman. And here's my thing about it. How are you not embarrassed with saying drizzle? All that's telling me is that you can't make it wet enough to rain. That's what drizzling is. When water...
She said you can't even get her wet. She said, you're not even man enough to get her wet. God, man, that's cold. Ho, 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 she going in on y'all.
It's falling from the sky, but it's not even worth calling it rain. It's just a drizzle. Like, it's not even raining outside enough to water your plants, but it's drizzling enough to dirty your fucking car after you washed it. Drizzle, drizzle. Drizzle, drizzle, because we don't know what it really feels like when she's wet. That's the one. That's it.
She said you dudes supposedly ain't got no women wet since you came out of your mom's womb. Damn, man, that's cold, man. Even though she ain't getting none in a long time as herself, because I could see by her face expression, it's been about 2 years. She ain't got none goody-goody in a long time. She looking for it, too. At the same time, she ain't get it in about a couple of years. Let's go.
You guys want to stick with that?
Oh, my goodness. Yo, I'm watching the whole, like, sprinkle, sprinkle, drizzle, drizzle stuff going on.
Witchy, the witcher. There's another witch. This is a witch right here. You see all the stuff she has? She's doing the witch stuff right now while she's talking. Let's go.
Oh, my God. All I can say is this. I'm out of that game, and I am in my cranky crone phase. I'm in my sizzle era, where I'm just burning away all the fucks I used to give.
Wow.
Just burning them away. Just burning away all the non-essential
stuff. You're doing witchcraft right now.
Sizzle from this cranky crone.
Hi, we're Visible. We're the wireless company.
Sizzle, sizzle movement. I don't know about you lot, but I am here for the sizzle, sizzle. Like, can someone...
All right, that's it. That's the last one. All right, let me bring in Zax. All right, Zax.
Oh, man, you should have brought me on when the thing was still going.
I didn't know you... I was focused, but go ahead, brother.
Oh, man.
You should have texted me, man.
Nah, you streaming. I didn't know what to do, but it is what it is.
Go ahead, brother.
I don't even know where to begin, but I guess where I left off is that the chicks who is supporting it, this nonsense, they don't really support the dudes. They just support the movement. And it's like, okay, if you support the dudes doing it, that means you were never against the women doing it.
Yep.
So all this stuff is a skit. And I was saying earlier in the chat, like, this is a dangerous skit because it's going against masculinity again.
Yeah.
And even the dudes are following what the women have been doing all this time.
Yeah.
And I was mentioning that that Ringo made a 9-hour stream, and he mentioned, like, the reason why the women are wicked is because the men are wicked. They're not even leading. Look at what they're doing.
Yeah.
They're doing the same exact thing. And if it backfires, I guarantee you they're gonna blame the women again. They're gonna keep blaming the women. They're not gonna hold themselves accountable.
It's gonna get worse. Yeah. It's gonna get worse.
It's gonna get so much worse. And this is the reason why. Listen, I'd just rather be by myself. I'd rather be by myself just chilling. Like, if any dude, I don't even care where it is, if it starts off at work, if some of these dudes grab hold of this stuff at work and they do that, fam, I'm not going to talk to them again. I'm not even going to lie. I'm not going to talk to them. Like, unless it's work related, like, fam, we can't be cool, man, because you looking crazy out here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, real talk, you looking real crazy. And it's an embarrassment to me. And it's an embarrassment to those who are actually trying to come up in the game as, you know, whether they're righteous, whether they're, you know, coming in the truth, or they just want to be men and they just want to get by in life.
Right.
It's going to be a huge detriment for all those type of men, because what does society in America, rather, what does society favor? They favor femininity. And it's not even just femininity amongst women. It's also amongst men, too.
Yep.
Yeah. James chapter 1, verse 8. the King James Version. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Think about it. Who's to say these men aren't going to be in that alternative lifestyle? You know what I'm saying? A lot of these women has toys. They're scared of heavy meat. Well, nah, no, they're not. They're not scared of heavy meat. They're just crazy. They're not scared because they get that too. It's easy to get that. It's easy to get that, especially if they allow themselves to get it. No.
Right.
That those toys, that's their God.
That's their God, yeah.
That's their God. They hate men, and they're gonna start having other men hate themselves even more.
Sprinkle's good. It's good with this. I believe she got a guy in on it. Whoever the guy who's the head honcho of it, she probably told him, yeah, do it for the men. We could make so much money off this.
Yo, and that's crazy, fam, because you like they messing up lives, fam. Yep. Men and women's lives. Souls gone,
yeah. There's particular YouTubers that's agreeing with it, and I'm gonna go in on them. Angry Man, you one of them, bro. You thought about that idea, man, bro. Angry Man, you down with the skits too? We're gonna do a review of your video. Don't try to get angry with me, because I'm about to go in on you, because you did a live stream. You talking about, you thought about the idea. I got receipts on you. You and that dude, what's his face? The dude from Detroit that he went to go visit.
I don't even know. I don't know these people.
Oh man, what's his name? Somebody know what I'm talking about. He used to have the show called Flight Club. Antoine Daniels.
You from Detroit?
Yeah, he's from Detroit.
I know that. It is what it is. What's going on, Sam?
What up, Sam?
Hey, how you doing, man?
What's good?
Chilling. Yeah, man, just like Zats, I was just listening in. But, like, the videos you played, some of them unbelievable. I ain't gonna lie. If y'all don't mind, I just want to spit this verse right quick.
Go ahead.
It's out of Proverbs. Chapter 8, verse 13. I think it fits very perfect for this. So let me know what y'all think about this. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil. Pride, arrogancy, the evil way, and the froward mouth do I hate. Froward, for those you know who might not know, it just means difficult to deal with. A lot of these women have that on top of the arrogancy. But really, it's just what I see, at least, is pride. Like Zass had just said, and I'm pretty sure you agree with this, Rollo, like there's a big inverse with how we're operating, just as like the people we're supposed to be, men and women. A lot of men with this little soft guy air crap, like one of the girls said, is zesty, you know, it's putting them on the map. It's showing who's really a man and who's really a woman, because this response to how women act is feminine, to be honest, to mirror what they're doing instead of step up and be like, okay, this is what a man is, this is what I'm gonna do. If you're not going to follow these guidelines, like move on my face type shit. But like, they're not doing that at all. Instead, they're mimicking what a woman does, what the modern woman does, the brain dead one does. And in turn, they want what results? Respect. I don't know what you get out of that, but that sounds childish to me. And the fact that this is actually a trend, I haven't seen it yet on my timeline. It's ridiculous, bro, because I don't mean to ramble. This is, I'm going to end it off here. Like, I was literally just watching some films earlier because I was just having, like, background noise. You know how I do, like, in the back. And I was on Netflix. And they still had The Matrix up there after the first one got done. So I just put that on as some background noise. I started to watch it. Got pretty deep in it about halfway. And I saw some things that I didn't notice at first. But just to get to the gist of it, bro, at the beginning of the movie, before really anything begins, of course, you have like Morpheus and Trinity talking about how they're about to snatch up Neo at the Matrix. Notice where it goes into. The numbers blinking on the screen, of course. It's inside these phones, these laptops. a lot of people, this is where the Matrix is. It's these phones, this laptop, this internet. It's a whole different dimension, but we just can't step into it yet. That's the only difference. It's just like the real world. All the information, everyone's on it. It's just that only thing is we can't live in it yet, but that's what they're trying to do. But for the most part, people spend their lives on here. And I feel like this is where these men got this idea from. They saw other men doing it, then it became a trend. Now it's a movement. Instead of men moving on the land with New Breed, for example, or doing something similar to Pastor Dow, not the whole thing, the camp, the church thing, but congregating, being men, bruh, like using their resources to actually make a difference instead of just a response like a woman. Like, I'm gonna stop right there before I start cussing, because it's dumb.
The thing about it, guys, is when I had that conversation with Ringo and New Breed, you know, March 29th, 2024, I didn't expect it to happen this fast. Just like when I talked about the fire last year by the Lord's doing in Christ, and it happened within a couple of months. You guys in the northern states, particularly New York, more so got to the point they couldn't breathe. So it's like, now the question I have for people in the chat, this is going to be a growing trend going into the summer. And it's crazy because there's a higher percent chance that more guys your age group, Zach and Samuel, is going to be the ones they're trying to attract to this. Some of the guys my age may fall for the okie-doke because some of them ain't wise just because they're my age. So the Isaiah 4:1 is going to be ramping up, I believe, more so in the summertime. Because based on the conversation I had with Lola V, did y'all see the video? Did y'all watch it?
I believe so.
You watched the Lola V? Who watched the Lola V? Put the one in the chat if you watched the interview with me and Lola Lee. Put the one in the chat.
You mean Lola V?
Yeah, Lola Lee. The one I had came to my place, to the studio.
Yeah, I caught a little bit of that.
I saw it this morning.
That was a strong conversation. That's how men and women are supposed to talk to each other. Right. That's how you're supposed to talk to each other. Like, you could have a disagreement, and if you notice, she said she would look into what I said. Why? Because I said it with conviction. Most men don't have conviction when they talk to these ladies. That's why they want to be women.
You mean
they want to be women because they think that's the easy way to get a woman is to be a woman. That's madness, man.
You mean confidence?
You could be confident and still don't have the presence of letting her see that you could lead the way. There's a lot of men with confidence and they can't lead the way.
Yeah, I got you. I was a little bit confused by what.
If you think about it, you see how me and her was talking the same time without even interrupting each other.
Right.
That it's got to be in you. Most guys cannot do the double talk without interfering each other's conversation.
Right.
It's got to be in you. So it was in her and it's in me. That's why I know that we have a chemistry, because that wasn't scripted. That was just off the dome. Yeah, she had notes for me at that particular time. And I said to her, we're going to do this off the dome. It's going to be masterful. The Most High made sure she didn't bring those notes, because most ladies want to be more prepared when they deal with me at the same time. I'm like, yo, let me lead by example. And she just followed the lead, and it was a masterful. So it gets to a point that when you are settled with the Lord in Christ, you don't have to go softball error. Women going to want to be with a man eventually. You just have to put yourself in that situation. These dudes are not men. These women are responding because the witches and warlock got war with each other. You got to think about it. Like I said to New Breed respectfully and Ringo, and Mark the Messenger, the shift has changed. It's our time. We just explain it to those that watch my channel that's not in the truth. Because there's people that watch my channel not in the truth. And so they have to also watch out, because even though they may not believe in the word, that doesn't necessarily mean they don't know what's going on in these streets. They got to know what's going on in these streets too. You get what I'm saying? So, hey man, you young guys, you got to, that's why I get you guys, when you get time, start doing content, because you had a lot of so-called black men following this so-called white man that was at the airport. He's the one who knows Sprinkle. And he's in his 50s and 60s talking like that.
That's crazy.
They wanted to, they're not going to force you to depopulate. This is the thing you got to understand. They're not going to force you to depopulate. Men are choosing to depopulate the world. Not the powers that be. It's no such thing as forcing. The devil never force you to do anything.
I was saying, like, that's like just the power of influence. It's not more so peer pressure, but it's just like, it's like they're selling you some sort of advertisement, and then wham, you're already sold. You're already sold. Keyword sold.
Yep.
Sold. You know? And it's like, it's just so swift. It's so easy. Like, yo, the devil's very cunning.
And the thing with Angry Man is, what it shows me, if he thought about that, it's with him is, he might as well just say he ain't Hollywood, because why would you, as a married man, would think about a soft error in your mind? Mm. That don't make no sense. That's why I said every man that's not, it's like Dirty Dower. A lot of these men, they married, they have children, doesn't mean they a man. Because ain't no man in his right mind going to be like, oh, I want to count about the soft girl error and sprinkle. Let me do drizzle. No. That's why I say even some of these married men are questionable. Go ahead.
Dude, it's the fact that it's called soft boy error, fam. We grown ass men, fam.
That's facts.
Bro. The fact that you're saying there was like a 6-year-old like pretty much promoting it, I'm like, fam, what?
That's facts.
And nobody's forcing this. Nobody's putting a gun to our head. Nah, it, like you said, Rollo, we're just choosing to do it. And it's mm-hmm. all influential.
Mm-hmm. On TikTok, and you wonder why the other countries like China and all these other places is removing TikTok.
Damn, I got a TikTok.
Teaching more masculine things.
I got a TikTok, and even though I post like content on there, I don't really go on there. Like my content, like it's, you know, it's mostly photography. It's actually all photography and video-based photography. But at the same time, it's like, I don't really go on there because, yo, honestly, it's an app for the dumbed down. I'm not even gonna lie.
Mm-hmm.
It's an app for the dumbed down. Like I'll go on it, I'll find some great content on there, but just depending on where I am, it feels like that I'm just tuned into the drama. And I've never heard of the soft boy era until I'm on this stream, until this stream. Mm-hmm. I have not experienced that. I've not witnessed that until this stream today. I'm like, what is this? And then mm-hmm. I'm hearing drizzle. I'm like, what? And then I'm hearing the whole dialogue from these grown dudes. And I'm like, you sound like a woman.
Yep.
You sound like the same woman you hate. How is it any different? How is it any different of a woman calling a man a misogynist, but they're doing the same exact thing they're calling the man a misogynist are doing?
Mm-hmm.
You're doing the same exact thing. It's weird, fam. It's weird.
Yeah.
And like, it's not even funny anymore. It's not funny. It's not funny, man. Like, it's weird, fam. Like, and this is the reason why I'd just be wanting to stay by myself. I don't even want to hang out with people like that.
Yeah.
I'm better off just staying to myself, doing what I do, go to work, go home, work out, whether it's at the gym or at home, drive, travel, whatever. I can't even stay. Fam, if I even stay, you know, like respectfully speaking, like, you know, no crazy stuff. If I even hang around men for too long, I get annoyed. I'd rather just literally stay by myself. I don't care. Like, if I stay around women too long, I get annoyed. If I stay around men too long, I get annoyed. Things just, it's just weird for some reason.
Yeah.
And all this happened right after the eclipse.
Yep.
That's crazy.
Anything for attention. Last thoughts, fellas, because I got to get ready for the early shift.
Oh, yeah, same. Yeah, you can go, Samuel. Since you just got here, you can speak your piece too, man.
For sure. Yeah, man. Honestly, everything y'all said about this topic was on point because it's true. Like a lot of what we're seeing, like it says in the book, the Most High is not the author of confusion. And obviously what this movement is regression, if we're going to be honest. This is nothing positive. It's not anything that anybody should get behind. If you're new viewing this, new to this channel, we do not stand with the soft boy movement just because it's putting us backwards, bro. This is not how men should be looked at, especially in the public eye, but they're doing it to themselves. So what more can we do? You know, we just gonna stand how we stand. But honestly, I do think that this is all coming from Satan. What people perceive as Satan is really just a demiurge, you know, the one who wants to be like the Most High. In Gnosticism, that's defined as just a prideful, inferior being that creates the material world. Honestly, I don't want to say the other part, but it's true. It says it's also frequently identified with the Creator God in the Hebrew Bible, just like the devil wants to be like the Most High. That's what the demiurge is. And giving pretty much way to the physical realm makes archons, you know, these what they call planets, you know, Saturn, you know, they call Venus, these are energies, you know, that's why they shine so bright, just like the sun. You know, that's not the sun reflecting off of that. These are luminaries that have effects on this realm that we're in. And you got to serve the Most High or else you're going to get to these things, to these energies. So these tarot cards, these crystals that people are playing with, if you do not know how to program a crystal, you should not be buying one. I don't even know how to do that. So that's why I don't buy them. Because it's not for me, obviously. The people who had the knowledge of that do not exist no more. Unless you could levitate in front of me, unless you could bring someone back from the dead such as Christ without using his name or without even believing in him, then I'll believe you. But other than that, you need to stay away from this crap. But that's all I had to say, honestly. Thank you for letting me on. Good talking to y'all brothers, man. I do appreciate it. You know, I got, you know, just a quick shout out. I got me some music. If y'all like music and want to listen to that, I just dropped 12 on my second page. Y'all check that out if y'all want to. But make sure more and first of all, most definitely. For sure. Thank you. I appreciate that. But more than most, like, any before that, man, like, we had to support Rallo, obviously, because this time and him being unmonetized and all this work he's still putting in for y'all. Crazy. If yeah. I don't, like, if y'all ain't supporting, then y'all crazy, because he is still putting in work just like he's still getting paid. So y'all better at least reward him for his efforts. But that's all I had to say for tonight, man. Y'all be easy, you know what I mean? Let's get ready for the week. At least knock the rest of that out. But yeah, man, y'all be easy, bro. Peace.
All right, brother Zax.
Hey, I'ma just keep it a buck, fam. Like, call it out. If they do some weird stuff like this, call it out. I don't care if you're a man or a woman. If you see something that's weird from a dude, call it out.
Yeah.
Soft guy nonsense is crazy. And, you know, like, sometimes, you know, we make jokes here and there, but it's like, yo, they really are embracing it. They're, and it's different when you're just joking around, but if you embracing it, nah, I'm not with that. I'm serious. Like, we got to call it out. That's... We can't, because if we're not saying anything, it's like low-key we're kind of supporting it, or you're afraid that you're going to get criticized or fired from your job or something. Like, if you really care about the person, if you really care about dude, like, let's say, for instance, my homeboys, they start doing that soft guy nonsense, I'm going to call it out. I'm like, yo, you suspect, bro. Respectfully, you suspect.
Yeah.
Or if they're ladies... If their ladies see the same thing, she better say something like, hey, you kind of suspect. You know what I'm saying? It's these celebs pushing these agendas. Of course it is. But why do we have to listen to these celebrities? We are our own people.
That's right.
I'm not listening. That's the same thing when these celebrities started pushing that that thing in 2020 and in 2021. I'm not, nah. I didn't listen to them. Yeah, I did what I did. I repented at the same time. It wasn't against my will.
You chose to do it, yep.
I chose to do it, not because I was afraid. I already lost my job, so it didn't matter. I lost my job before this thing even, you know, was so heavy about it. But, you know, at the topic at hand, man, yo, we need men to be men again, man, for real, because it's getting crazy. And some men, you know, even men my age, they coming up in the game trying to, you know, better themselves as being men. And I applaud them for that. I really got to salute those brothers, even the young brothers coming in the game, man. We cannot have them be like this, man. This is some serious times. For real, like, if I see dude doing some crazy stuff, I'm going to call it out. I might, you know, pull him to the side. Hey, bro, that's suspect, fam. Same thing with the ladies. Call it out. We got to start holding people accountable. We really got to start holding people accountable. Like, heavy. And if they don't want to listen, okay, let it go. Let them do what they got to do. You said, your hands are clean. Your hands are clean. That's it.
Pure, it has nothing to do with that. Pure, they're going about it the way they're not. They you could, them dudes are retrobates. They're not, they don't have no principle. So even if those women take those dudes out, they still want to complain. They want to be women. We're not giving these guys a pass. They want to be like you ladies. There's ladies that took me out. I don't have no issue with ladies, you know, took me out to dinner and stuff like that. That has nothing to do with it. The thing is that these men want to be you. That's what we're trying to, that's what we're talking about. And I know you know that, respectfully. Yeah, so I appreciate you coming on, Zaz, with your assessment as well. And Samuel, appreciate you coming on. See you on the next one.
Inviting me. I appreciate you inviting me, sir.
All right. Thank you for coming on.
Please.
All right, let me read the scripture. 1 Corinthians 13:11. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. Absolutely. So let me shout out the support. Mrs. KK, thank you again. I appreciate your support, Mrs. KK. Salute to you. And shout out to Corey, the member Corey, for the support. Thank y'all for the support. Those are the only two that supported the stream. I appreciate y'all two supporting. Thank y'all for liking the video, sharing the video. We will be talking about this again at a later date. So I got to get ready for the shift around the corner. And for those who know, I'm coming to see you, so be ready. I'm not going to say where I'm going. It's around the corner. I'm looking forward to this trip. Do not mention the dates in the chat. So some of you, I'm looking forward to seeing you around the corner. So be ready. Going to meet some of my supporters, and we're going to have a good time. Thank you again, Ms. KK, the Maid of Most High. Keep on rewarding you abundantly, Ms. KK. And to Corey, bro, appreciate that support in the Cash App. Keep doing your thing. Time to level up, homie. Time to level up. To Samuel coming on the platform, to Zach coming on the platform, thank you for coming on, brothers. Wisdom, Sika, and everybody else tuning in. Charity Ivy, Jacqueline, Carter, all the mods, appreciate y'all making sure the stream is going real good. Until next time, I see y'all tomorrow. Peace. As you know, the Soonery and Tunery in Shineville, America, and throughout the Western Sir, Western society, Western side society remains at an all-time high. Shaking my head. Might as well play this song. Might as well play this song on the way out. This is how you talk to a lady. We don't do soft guy errors over here. We're going to play the clip of me and whatchamacallit in Jamaica and the clip I did with Lodi V. Stay tuned.
Oh, yeah. When I was in Jamaica for 2019 for my B-Day. Oh, yeah. You see what's going on there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. When I was in Jamaica 2019 for my B-Day week, going into almost the following year. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You already know what it is.
All right, let's go to my channel. What's going on with my channel? Okay, there we go. What's going on? My live is not working. Hold on a second, y'all. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Can y'all hear me? She says, I'm going to Jamaica or Tahiti for my birthday in June this year. Oh, that's what I'm talking about, Jacqueline. That's what I'm talking about. I don't know what's going on. YouTube must be shut down, y'all. Let me see something. I can't go to my channel, my live video on my phone, on my tablet. Anyway, I appreciate y'all tuning in. I'll talk with y'all another time. Y'all take it easy and peace.